Hello, this is Michelle Knight. Welcome to your weekly astrology. This week, we have a magical and mystical Venus and Neptune conjunction, and then a Moon, Venus and Neptune conjunction. Look out for past life connections, but don't get paranoid as it's all squaring Mars. Here's your weekly astrology. Aries, you magnificent warrior soul. This week, you're stepping away, sort of, from the warrior vibe, and you're very in tune with your emotions. It kicks off with Venus and Neptune in your place of romance, spirituality, just that sense of bonding and empathy and compassion. You're feeling very open and very in tune. You might even notice some strange, magical and mystical experience happen with you and another being. It may be that you have this profound, intimate moment with someone and it just feels magical. Now, having said that, you're so open that you might find yourself being defensive or feeling a bit vulnerable or not feeling yourself. And that's because all of this lovely, mystical, gentle, romantic, enlightening, super psychic stuff is squaring, creating tension with Mars, your ruler. So it may be that somebody says something inappropriate. Maybe they don't mean to say it. Perhaps you say something inappropriate because Mars at the moment is in this kind of adventurous, outgoing, bit of a truth monster space. But be aware that everybody is just open. We're all walking around without our armor on this week. So it's super important that we're sensitive and empathetic and tune in to our spirituality, tune in to our connection with everyone and sort of follow a more magical path this week rather than a go, go, go path of last week and the past few weeks. So it's our chance to really look at where we want to go, to visualize the future, to create our reality and to open up to magic without sort of clashing. Don't sort of be regretful. Don't be too maudlin. Don't think about the past. This is our moment right now. And each bit of magic, each bit of belief that you put out there will blossom and grow. We also have a sense of caution because we have Mercury going into retro shadow. I know, we used to think, you know, out there, all the memes were about Mercury retrograde, but guess what? The truth is, it starts to get a bit dicey a little bit before. So retro shadow is not Mercury wandering around in a pair of flares. It is about, you know, slight misunderstandings. And for you, that's going to manifest, or not going to, because I don't want to put that up to the universe, could manifest in groups and in your friendship, sort of misunderstandings. But having said that, you're super excited by working with groups and opening up to the possibility of real union and magic. So use that empathy to navigate you through. Sending you so much love. Take care, and I'll speak to you soon. If you want to check out your written monthly, weekly, yearly astrology, pop over to my website, michellenight.com. I'm not doing readings at the moment, but I do have a company of some of the best psychics and astrologers in the world. I've had the company for 20 years. I handpick them and they are fabulous. So I'm going to start to show you, starting now, their little videos on here.
I'm Rosie. I'm a medium clairvoyant. I have a spirit guide who channels messages to me. The mediumship is absolutely wonderful because I'm just the messenger. I can empathise most definitely with people. I will also pick up on their emotions immediately as soon as I connect with someone. I'd like to describe myself as quite wise, a lot of life experience. I can identify a lot with a lot of the callers. I think if you've clocked up a few decades on this planet, it helps to make you a better reader because you can put yourself where the caller is. I like to really give people something about themselves, potentials in their own lives. Yeah, I like to be able to help people and empower them in some way, give them some answers if I can. I take my job very seriously because it's just people's lives you're dealing with. When somebody says to me, "Thank you, Rosie, I feel so much better talking to you," and I will often feel quite tearful myself, and I think, job done.